Hey, what's up guys? You're watching Theojo Tech, and today we're going to be talking about autonomous cars, because recently Ford has said they want to release level 4 autonomous cars by 2021. So I thought we would talk about what exactly that means and get a little bit more into it. So in 2013, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration released a report that classifies different types of self-driving cars. There are different levels. There's 5 total from 0 to 4, each additional level meaning the car can do more stuff to drive itself. There is another classification system by the Society of Automotive Engineers that goes from 0 to 5, so it's 6 levels, but it's kind of similar, so I'm not really gonna get into that one. So why don't I go over what the different levels mean, and this will be from the NHTSA's system, not the Society of Automotive Engineers. Level 0 is pretty easy to understand. There is no autonomous features at all. The driver has to do absolutely everything. Level 1 is the first stage of autonomy, and that's when the car can do a single automated function at once. So it can do adaptive cruise control, it can do automatic braking, but none of these at the same time. Then level 2 is when the car can do 2 or more automated functions at the same time. So for example, it can do lane keeping as well as automatic braking or adaptive cruise control. It can do more than one thing at once, but for the most part, the user still has to be aware and take control of the car at any time. Level 3 is where it really starts to get interesting. That is when the car is able to perform all safety critical functions in certain conditions. So in some situations, it could be fully autonomous, but in others it wouldn't. For example, maybe only on the highway, or maybe only in an enclosed campus or something like that. It can locally do it, but it can't go out on the street. It'll depend on the specific car and the purpose of it, but basically it will require sometimes to turn over control to the user. However, one of the biggest differences between level 2 and level 3 is the amount of time you have to switch over. So with level 2, the user really has to be attentive and immediately be able to take control of the car at any time. At level 3, it says it has to give a comfortable amount of time to switch over. So it can't just immediately say, oh my gosh, you have to take control right now, otherwise it would be level 2. Level 3 should have some sort of warning system that says, all right, you're gonna have to start to take control soon, but not right away. So that could mean that you could stop focusing on the road and maybe do some work, because it will give you ample amount of time to switch over if it needs you. And we don't actually have any level 3 cars yet. Tesla, you might think with their autopilot system, would be level 3, but it's not, and I'll get into that a little bit later. Finally, level 4 is where the car is basically fully autonomous. It can perform all safety critical features such as driving, braking, parking, all that, and does not expect the user to have to intervene at all. And also, one of the cool things about level 4 is it would not need a person in the car at all. If it wanted to, it could drive across town. Now, level 3 might be able to not need a driver in the car sometimes. The example I gave is maybe like on a college campus in certain conditions where it knows the entire environment and, you know, it can just shuttle people around without needing someone to drive it, but then once the conditions change, it can't exactly go on the road, for example. But with level 4 then, it's autonomous in every situation. So where are we today then? Well, one of the best examples today that you might see is Tesla's autopilot feature, and that basically lets the car drive itself on the highways. And you might think, okay, well that's a certain condition where it's fully autonomous, that would be level 3, right? Not exactly, because Tesla still requires you to be able to take over the controls at an instant, at any time. You really are not supposed to take your eyes off the road at all with Tesla's autopilot system. So it is not level 3, but it can do multiple functions, so it would be level 2. For example, it can do lane keeping, it can do braking and stop and go traffic, that sort of thing. So it does do more than one function and can basically drive itself sometimes, but it still relies on you to take back control if there's an issue. Now, you may also know about Google's car. That's the self-driving car they're trying to make, and that's trying to be level 4, but it isn't quite. It's still basically level 2 because they always have a person in there that is ready to immediately take over control, or I think maybe they've done tests where there's no person in it, but they probably make it just shut down if it doesn't know what to do. However, I'm not really up to date on everything it's capable of. It's possible that it is fully capable when just driving around the Google campus. And I guess in that sense, it would be level 3 because in that certain condition, when it's on the campus, it knows everything about it. It knows exactly what to do. It's not gonna get any surprises. So it may be level 3. But even if it's not, I expect it's probably pretty close at this point. Now, Ford has said that they want to release by 2021 level 4 autonomous cars, but not by the system we just described. It's another system by the Society of Automotive Engineers, which is a little bit different. So with the SAE system, there's kind of like an extra level. Level 4 would mean that it is fully autonomous basically all the time, except in a few certain situations such as severe weather, but all the other times it can just do everything. And you would basically need to enable the self-driving function only when it's safe. And then once you do that, it becomes fully autonomous. You're not expected to take control at all, but you do have to decide whether you want it to do that or not. But SAE level 5 would be fully autonomous all the time, no matter what. So Ford doesn't think they can do that by 2021. It's the previous one. Ford has also said that they would probably use these cars for ride sharing. And we know that Uber, for example, has said they want to buy up autonomous cars and just do self-driving cabs and rides and that sort of thing, which would be pretty awesome. And I guess a lot of companies are also seeing that this is a potential moneymaker, that you could just not even have to hire drivers, you just have the car do everything and people pay money to ride in them. But I think the most crazy thing about all this is how soon we might be getting these cars. I mean, 2021 is just 5 years away. If they can stick to this schedule, that would be amazing. Just imagine calling up an Uber, a driverless car shows up, you get in, it takes you to your destination and you're done. Now, I'm sure it'll be much longer before they completely get rid of drivers. For example, if it's raining, I'm sure that these cars won't be able to handle that right at the beginning, but it probably would be eventually that there won't be any more cabs or anything like that. Not to mention, these cars are most likely going to be very expensive at the beginning, so there won't be that many, but I expect that if they are able to release these as a proof of concept, other companies are going to follow suit and we'll start to see more and more of these, of course. So as is typical, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens, but I am very hopeful that we'll get these awesome self-driving cars. Even if we won't be able to afford them anytime soon, maybe we'll be able to use them as ride sharing. I would like to know, of course, what you guys think. We can talk about this down in the comment section. Like, would you get in a self-driving car? Would you not trust it? We could talk about all that. If you did like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it. And if you want to keep watching, I've got some other videos on the right-hand side. You can just click those or look in the description for the same link, like if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos multiple times a week, so it should be worth it. So as usual, thank you guys for watching. Look forward to hearing from you. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.